Throughout the years, dance has played a major role in the distribution of music. The likes of Akosie Ejapon and Slim Buster, among others, paved the way for the new talents we see now. It is now believed by a number of people that dance increases the virality of music. Do you agree? Today, we step out to speak to some stakeholders in the dance community, a musician, a music producer, and seek the views of you out there on the role dance plays in music production and distribution and why it should be given more attention.
Music is actually a star on its own. Music can create itself as a dance. That's for my side. But for dance, dance can't be on its own without music. So I think music makes dance, whilst dance actually needs music to go with it. That's what I know for that one.
For me, I think it goes together. Yeah, because without the music, the dance won't be relevant. And without the dance too, the music, maybe the music would be relevant, but to reach certain audience, you know, it won't get there. So I think music and dance goes together.
Some music need dance to be able to blow, while some they don't even need the dance. It depends on the type of music. So either ways, the music can. Some need the dance and some also don't need the dance. So
I do like inspirational songs. So I don't really look at the dancing per se, but I look about. I actually think and look at the words that come out from the music. So if the music doesn't sound more to me, I don't value it.
So I was trying a little Tuesday, but I'm going to leave that to the professionals. I'm here with somebody who is very prominent in the dance space, the music space, and today I want us to talk about dance and music. But first, Pablos, talent manager for DWP, you've been doing this for a while. I just want to know, how's the journey been so far, man?
It's been a very crazy journey. So like, I'm a co-founder and I manage academy as well.
Okay.
And I mean, this, we started this, like I can say it's been like 10 years, but wow. The academy has been there for like 5 years.
Wow.
Because I was managing, you know, Dance God Lloyd and Afrobeast. Mm-hmm. And then 5 years later, we were like, okay, let's start something that will like, you know, groom the next generation. And it's not been easy because like, you know, back then nobody respected dancers.
Yeah,
like nobody's even gonna pay you, you know, for to come and dance. You know, they feel like they are putting you on. You know, so it's been very difficult, like, you know, like building the brand to the point where now people realize that, like,
okay, so
it has value.
That's what I want to talk about. And this is a very weird question for me to ask. Why do you think dance took some time to catch on, right? Because back in the day, we had Slim Buster, we had Akosie Ejapon, but right now, dancers are doing well financially, recognition-wise, they have more traction.
Mm-hmm.
Why is that the case? And dance has always been a part of music.
Yeah.
Look at Michael Jackson, look at Chris Brown, Usher, right?
Yeah.
Why do you think here more so it wasn't the case?
I think it's how we went about it, branding wise, and the perception people had about it. You know, because people used to think that dance was for people that are like, you know, school dropouts or people that don't have anything to do. You know, but now we're like, you know, most of the academic guys are in Lagos. They are balancing the academics and the dance. You know, so like, you know, parents are actually encouraging their children. So I feel like it's a perception thing. You know, the perception about it back then is different from what it is now. Yeah.
What are you guys doing to, you know, add to the changing of that perception? Is it, again, like I said, is it the recognition? Is it that right now finances are better? Is it because of social media? What are you doing as DWP and as yourself doing this for so long to change the minds of people?
I think social media has been like a main tool that we've used. You know, like it's like if nobody's gonna put us on, they're gonna put us on. You know, so branding wise, like, you know, the kind of videos we put out there. You know, the challenges that we run, you know, and if you put like all of the members together on social media, we have like more than 10 million followers.
Yeah,
you know, so social media is like our, you know, means of communication, you know, the things that we say, what we preach, and everything. What else? Aside social media, performances that we do. You see dancers on stage and you know they're dressed anyhow, or we are probably even trying to look just like the artist, you know, with the whole costume and everything. So that's how we're trying to change the perception.
Endorsements are crazy. Yeah, I hear money's been coming in. I'm doing it. So it's all good and well, but what's the plan moving forward? Because like you said, now things are in place, you know, for young kids. And that's the thing. Even school dropouts are doing well financially, right?
Yeah.
And again, that's a good avenue to take.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the plan moving forward?
So you know, the reason why we started DWP is so that like you know whatever. We started with dance, girl, and Afrobeat, that will die. You know, like there's another generation, you know. So right now we have like average like 22, 21, 20. There's another generation who is like 15 and above. That's also like, you know, in 5 years or in 3 years, like, you know, they will also be as big as, you know, this one. And the goal is to like have our own institution, you know, where we can even have like people from outside come for exchange programs. You know, we want to be like, want it to be like a school. So you're learning dance, but like there's you know, maybe there's a computer lab, there's, you know, there's a science lab, you know, you're learning everything like a school. You know, that's the whole thing, you know, like that's the long-term goal.
But Pubbles, it mustn't be easy managing all these talents. You know, I'm assuming managing one artist.
Yeah,
it's a job, because you know, we all have creative as human beings, you have emotions,
yeah.
You know, in a good mood. So you have to be the one who's going to be in the middle to make sure everything falls in place. Tell me a little bit about that. Is it easy? Is it difficult? And how do you actually do it?
I'm not even going to lie. It's very difficult. Like, it's really difficult because everybody is different. Like, it's like you're dealing with everybody's emotions, you know, egos and everything. But like, you know, what I tell my people all the time is that if I get mad at you for something you did wrong, the work has to go on. Like, it's part of the work, you know, so they understand that, you know, if you're being corrected or if you are being, you know, guided in a certain way, you need to understand that it's part of the work. You know, there's been times I feel like, bro, do I still want to do this? But like, you know, I decided to choose this path, so I have to like go through with it. Yeah.
What do you want to tell young kids who want to be dancers? You know, who want to take the right path, so to speak.
I think that like you should really like follow your heart and whatever you want to do, like go after it, because you know. We knew we wanted to change something, but we wanted that we didn't think it was going to like change, you know, so many lives like this. Like, there's people that sell bread that are dancing now. Like, and then I used to work at the filling station now. She's a big, she's like the most followed dancer on TikTok right now. You know, so your life could change if you follow your dreams, you know. So never give up on whatever you believe in or whatever you want.
Well said. Mike, can we find you guys on social media? If there are dancers, I want to be a part of, you know, the team. Is it an easy process? Are there auditions? Is it a simple process? DM, how does that work?
So you can find us on Instagram, on every social media platform, DWP Academy. To be part of it, we do auditions like, you know, twice a year. And so once you come, if we think you're fit or you like you have the talent, then we choose you to be part of the academy. So it's very easy. You just have to look out for our auditions. We also have like classes every Wednesdays and Saturdays, which is open to everybody.
Okay.
You don't necessarily have to be a professional dancer. You can just come and learn.
I'm assuming all ages.
All ages. Like
grandmas and grandpas.
Everybody.
That's cool. Everybody. Thank you so much. Keep doing what you're doing. It's all about positive energy, I believe. You guys have done incredible. I'm assuming you're going to do bigger things. I'm praying and hoping that happens. God bless you, man.
Thank you very much.
Find this guy if you're a dancer. And you're going to be out of there. And he's going to do the Afrobeat.
Mad.
Y'all know I couldn't come to a dance studio and not talk to one of the biggest, most amazing, most talented dancers in the country.
Jai.
And dance, you know, I said this off air, I'm going to say this again. I'm proud of you for what you're doing as an artist, you know, as a human being, the positive energy you exude. It seems like you're somebody who's super, super focused on work all the time.
Yes.
And again, like I said, I could go on and on and on.
Yes.
But
yes.
I just want to know, is that who you've always been? Again, as a human being, even before your talent, the focus and the drive that you have, is that who you've always been?
That's who I've always been. Just that along the line, I found it very difficult to want to continue. But one thing I'm very, very grateful for is the fact that I never give up. I love challenges, actually.
That's good. But why was that the case? What was that roadblock that made you nearly give up?
Human beings. what I've been through, what my family have been through, especially my dad. You know, at some point I lost faith in human beings because of how they treated my father. But along the line, I was like, if my dad was here, he wouldn't want me to give up on myself, so why should I? You know, that's one of the things that kept motivating me. That's why I keep saying one of the things that inspire me to want to keep moving on is where I come from. Yes.
Yeah, and it's very incredible to see again, you know, your story, what you've been through. Has that mindset changed so far? Because the thing is, now you're pertaining to an audience, to a fan base. Sometimes they might not be in a good mood, sometimes they might be in a good mood, and they see you as a star, as a brand. How are you changing that perception yourself and even of people who are going through things like you are?
I try to be very authentic with everything I do, online, offline. And I usually tell my people to not see me as a star. I don't want to be put in that position, because then you treat me differently. And then you tend to want to be like not real with me. I like it when you're real with me, and especially when I have a lot of things to tell you, then I want to flow. But I always want to make sure if you're close to me, you have to be authentic with me, because I give it to you raw and I expect the same thing to be reciprocated.
Was it difficult for you being as big as, because no matter what you do, some people are still going to say you're a star, she's a star. Was it difficult for you, you know, to put this honesty out there, you know, with what you've been through with your family, nearly giving up? It's not easy to be honest, right? Yeah. In a social media world where everyone is a judge.
Yeah.
Was it easy for you, and how did you overcome that too?
It wasn't hard, because I felt like one of the reasons why I should tell my truth is for people out there that don't want to have the courage to step out and be like, this is where I was from, this is what I've been through. This society that we live in, everybody wants to, not everybody, but some people want to make it look like I'm perfect. I had the perfect life. I came out from the perfect background. But in my case, I want to make an exception, because my bed was not full of roses. I didn't have a silver spoon in my mouth. And I think there are people out there that are like me, that would want to hear a story like mine and also get motivated and be like, I came from grass and I'm headed to grace. That is the story I want to tell. I don't want to be known for, oh, she has been a star all her life, because I was not. You know, I want people to actually hear my story and be inspired to want to not give up on themselves.
We are inspired. But was it always dance? Was that always
dance? No. It wasn't always dance.
Tell me about that and how dance came into the picture.
I wanted to be a footballer. Big time, like, you know, juggle football. And I wanted to make it big time.
Really?
But then I had the talents for it, but I figured out that it wasn't my purpose. Mm. So I had to just duck football. I still do football, but it's just for the fun.
Okay.
But right now I dance.
And then dance came into play. What was that moment that you had? Dance is it. Like, this is the purpose. This is the movement. This is what I'm going to do forward. What was that moment?
Where I started receiving messages.
Oh.
Messages like someone I've never met before could actually text me essay. Like a very, very long essay. And be like, I've touched your life this way. Do you know I was depressed? And then after watching your videos, I felt this way. And these people, I didn't ever believe that I would meet them. There are people that I wouldn't want to mention names. They've called me on my line just to tell me, don't stop whatever you're doing, because you put smiles on our faces, both old, both young. And that is one of the things I want to fulfill in life. On my bio, it says to impact the young and the old. It's not just for the young generations. Yeah. I want to touch lives without even getting to see them physically, so that there's something they would have to talk about when I'm no more.
Nice. Yeah. And now dancers, it's become bigger, it's become better. What's the plan moving forward for you? You know, looking at everything you've been through, it's been a culmination up to now. What's the plan moving forward? Are we going to get more videos, more dancing?
More videos is going to keep coming. You are going to get tired at some point, but you're not going to get tired. I'll twist it up a little bit. Nice. But I have a bigger picture, and I'm doing dance full time, but I also have other plans. I have school plans, I have business plans, I have plans on traveling around the world, of course, expanding my family base and my fan base, and getting to teach dance. I want to touch those places that dance I've not touched.
Amen to that. When are we having our battle?
The battle.
I've been calling.
You're going to win, or what's
the new pick? You know, I want to win, but that's my baby girl. So, no, for now, but thank you so much. God bless
you. Thank you so much for having me.
I need a hand. Please find me. Where can you find me on social media?
You find me on Instagram, on YouTube, on TikTok, on Twitter, Snapchat. You can find me on Facebook, Endurance Brand, on all platforms.
Nice one.
No, what's it called? Underscore, right?
Yeah.
No underscore, just Endurance Brand.
Quickly also, what do you want to tell young boys and young girls out there who want to get into the dance space?
I would want to, my advice to the younger generation or even to the older generation is always learn to balance. If you have an education and then you have your talent, learn to balance talent and education together. Don't feel like you have a talent and then you're going to just abandon what you're supposed to do to make yourself better. And appreciate people around you, people that genuinely care for you. And please be humble. Being humble takes you places. Don't forget where you come from. It's very important.
Definitely. Yeah. Please find her, follow her. I'm going to leave her to dance because she was working and I had to
have
her
way. Enjoy. Superstar!
Turn it up. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3. Hey, come on. Hey, come on. Hey, come on. And 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3. Awa. Hey. Awa. Hey. Awa. Hey. Awa. Hey.
Today, I'm talking, like I said, to the coolest dancers, the most talented, the most amazing. Lisa's in the house. How you doing?
I'm okay.
Yeah. Lisa, I'm very happy to be here. Very happy to talk to you. I just want to know, are you used to the fact that you're a superstar? No. That everybody wants to take pictures with you and everybody wants to talk to you?
No, it's not normal. Like
are you enjoying it?
Yeah.
What was that moment that you that, nah, I have arrived as a dancer? Because the thing is, you've been doing this for a while.
Yeah.
Right? And now God is blessing you. You're out there. What was that moment that you...
I'll say there's no moment we have arrived yet. Just that there's a change from back then to now. There's a change. We are growing, but we've not arrived.
I like that energy. How do you stay grounded, right? And focused. And always have that mindset that I'm not there yet. I can keep going and going. Because, you know, comfort is going to destroy the dream, right? How do you keep that mindset?
We are taught here that we shouldn't get comfortable. Every day we hear that we shouldn't get comfortable because we've not reached. We are now starting. So it's in our mind that we've not reached yet. It's always said here that we shouldn't get comfortable. Consistency, because there's a lot to learn. And we are still learning. So that's basically it.
Was it always dance for you?
Not really.
When was that, again, turning point that you decided to focus on dancing?
From SHS. I started dancing because I didn't want to get punished in school, honestly.
Oh.
I was in Ghana National College.
How did dancing avoid you?
Because the form three is like dancers.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. Back in Ghana National College. It's an entertainment school basically. So
okay.
They like dancing.
Okay.
So I went to the DWP Academy to learn how to dance so that I will not get punished. Okay. And because of that, I was rolling with the form threes, you know.
Okay.
Rolling with the form threes.
Okay.
So
okay.
Yeah, then I was like, okay, why not I take this thing seriously? Then that's how come I moved to dance, because I was doing sports more. I was a basketball player, a hurdler, and a high jumper.
Damn, she's so talented.
Yeah.
Then dance has led to all of this thing, and I'm assuming you're very, very grateful because now you're getting endorsements, you're on big stages. I just want to know, when it comes to the dance, the talent, right? How do you select music and how does that work with the team?
Okay, so what we do here in Ghana is Afropop. So we select music based around Afro. So and then it's basically what you like that you dance to. So if you are really enjoying the song, that's what we dance. So basically that passion for the song that creates the dance.
Okay. And if people want to work with you, people want to be part of this, is it an easy process?
Very easy. There's no registration anywhere. You just come here, you pay 50 cedis and you start the dance class.
Okay, so it actually helped too?
Yes.
Oh.
So we are all teachers.
You want to teach him? Oh man, I should come to people and teach me one of these days.
Yeah,
teach me how to break it down. So what's the plan moving forward for Lisa? Because again, you've done so much and you're up to so much. What's the plan?
I'm still in school, so we are doing the two. I want to be an accountant as well.
Cash money. Is it easy? Is it difficult? Are you used to balancing school and dancing?
I'm not used to balancing school and dance, because back in SS, if you're in school because they're boarding school, and when you're home because it's vacation. But now sometimes class and dance rehearsal clash. You have to choose what's important. And of course school comes here before dance. But we are still doing school.
Is family okay with you?
My family is very fine because I'm very intelligent.
Hey, you know, when intelligent people meet intelligent people, we understand.
You know.
Lisa, where can we find you on social media? How can people support you?
My name is Lisa Kwama on all social media platforms. YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, everywhere, Lisa, Kwama. It's even on my necklace.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. You want to tell, you know, your fans out there something, you know, the dancers coming up, audience, what do you want to tell them?
I want to say, focus on what you want to do. Don't feel that what you are doing will not get anywhere, because when we started, dance wasn't relevant in the country. Now it is very relevant. So keep being consistent in what you do and don't give up.
Yeah.
Be prayerful.
Awesome. Awesome. Prayerful. Very, very important. I agree with that. Before you go, we usually get questions from the audience, from the fans. They want to know, do you think music needs dancers and dance right now?
Yes. Yes. Because you as, how do I say, you're an artist. To vibe to a song, you need to dance to it, right? That's the only way you enjoy the music. Okay. If you can't dance to it,
so the audience who are not artists need the dance.
Yes.
Oh, that's an interesting take.
Yeah.
Lisa, thank you so much. Well, you know,
thank you,
I pray for more blessings on you.
Amen.
The darling, I pray you're going to do bigger things. Amen. And I really like that you said being prayerful is very important,
very
because
important.
You know, we can't do none of this without God, right? Thank you so much.
You
please
God.
Find a fellow supporter. And I'm going to dance.
Hey.
Hi, my name is DJ Vyrusky, the turntable magician, the muse, and the virus is always spreading, the positive one, of course. The importance of dance to music production now. I think I always say that the world evolves, right? It was 1992, or it was BC, it was AD, then we came to the 90s, the 2000s, we are here now. And in this era, dance really, really controls a lot of songs. I mean, we're in the era of TikTok, Trailer, even Snapchat, people are on there doing a lot of dance challenges and all. So I think now producers, I mean even artists in general, take into consideration these things, because Sally, before you release a song, you always want to think about a dance challenge, otherwise your song, you will stay your own music. There are songs that are big without dance challenges. People by Libyanka didn't have any dance challenge, but it was like everywhere. But then the truth is, most of the songs are big now because of the dance challenges. I mean, just this year, from January till now, I think the two big Ghanaian songs now were challenges by Dance God Lloyd, right? Terminator and Butter My Bread. And I mean, we all do Terminator. So I think most of the challenges blue songs, like my own song, Body to Body, and it was doing well on the DSPs and everything, but for it to go to the streets and everywhere, DWP had to come in, and they took the song, they made it their own, and they just kicked off everything with it. So nobody can say that it doesn't really play like a big part in that, because the video said the dance, Charlie Dawson, in the video. Charlie, you catch there. I mean, with music production, I think as a great artist, you shouldn't just follow trends, because I mean, the trends always change. The next time you wake up, maybe it is maybe Kukunti challenge or something that is going to get the songs going. So, I mean, I know a lot of artists normally do songs with a lot of challenges in mind. They are viral songs, they are TikTok songs, but there are songs that also convey a lot of, I mean, last didn't have any dance challenge, but it went. I mean, talking about Ghana, there are a lot of songs that has become big without like dance challenges and all that. So Chatawali's On God didn't have a dance challenge for it, but it was all everywhere. So I mean, as an artist, you don't just go to the studio because you just want to come up with a dance challenge, otherwise you're a dancer now. Do you understand? But I mean, we won't neglect them. They play a very big part in making our songs big. So yeah, I even want to start a dance school. I mean, I'm just trying to say that. I mean, that's what's popping now. Everybody's doing now. There are lots of dancers coming up. I mean, I mentioned DWP. There's Ziggy's group, Incredible Ziggy. Dance God, who is, I don't think he's part of DWP now, but he has his own group now. There's Dance to the Tune by Lynx Entertainment. So I think it's something we can't live without, do you understand? So let's just embrace it. Take very good advantage of it. Because when you drop a song and you feel you need a dance challenge to make it go, I mean, you just do it. Because most of the big songs from last year to this year were because of challenges. I mean, Kiddy's Touch It was because one lady in East Africa just decided to do Shut Up and Bend Over, and everybody just picked it up. Do you understand? So sometimes you do dance challenges and they don't even go, right? Because I mean, we Touch It, we did the whole dance challenge, but it didn't go anywhere. One lady just decided to just Shut Up and Bend Over, and everybody wanted to see the bend. Collaborate. So everything was like that. So you have to just take advantage of that, and we are going to maximize that. But like, you want to ask me a trick question? Me, I don't know the answer. They are my friends. I mean, Ziggy is doing this because there's, I mean, as of now, Ziggy is championing the Ampute, that, right? That's by Stoneboy. Dance God did for Terminator and Butter My Bread. And I think they're all doing their stuff. So for now, everybody's great. I mean, Quabos is my guy. I mean, DWP, they're my people. Afonita, Demzy, they're like my G's. So, and everybody expects me to mention their name because I'm cool with them extra. But I think everybody else is doing their own thing. And that's the thing. I want to use this opportunity to say this, that let's just support everybody as Ghanaians. We shouldn't try and always pick favorites. I think that's why sometimes we suffer. That's why we are always comparing ourselves to the Nigerians and all that. Let's just all come together. If DWP is good, let's just say, oh, DWP is good. But don't say DWP is good. They are better than this. Like, do you understand? You can just say Ziggy is good and leave it as Ziggy is good. And yeah, we'll go. I think everybody is allowed to feel a certain way about what they think they are. Right, I normally don't really pay attention to all those things because I just see the person as trying to market themselves. Because, of course, like I saw a tweet by Dance God that this year he's made 2 songs blow in a month. I mean, of course, he came up with a challenge and he feels that's what blew the song, but there are lots of other factors that blow songs, right? Sometimes you feel it's your TikTok challenge, but maybe Apple Music, maybe Spotify, maybe some DJs on Pop. Right, it's doing some work that you don't know. So that DJ in that pop too feels like me, I made the song blue for the whole new world. Do you understand? So I feel everybody's entitled to however they feel. So if you have my song, the most important thing is make it blue. Take the credit, I will chop the money. Would you be my person? Body on my body, your loving sweet pass by me. I just wanna be by your side.
Somebody call me Diana. Oh. What's up, people? It's your boy Mr. Drew from Ghana. I do Afrobeat and High Life. Let's go. So the impact of dance in my music career, well, one, it sets me apart from everybody else who's doing music, because I combine dance and then music to create, you know, a wonderful experience for my fans. In terms of stage performances, I'm always, you know, putting my dancers on, inputting, you know, crazy choreographies in there. And I feel like me having a dance background actually helped me to always think about what I want to do on stage, meditate on it, think about what I can do to always give my fans like a different experience all the time. So yeah, definitely being a dancer before has given me a wider scope of what I want to do usually on stage, you understand? Also with writing music, I always look at performing the music to the people. So that also plays a role in me making music and then releasing it. Music used to do really, really well before, you know, dance challenges became a thing. if the music is good, it's good. You can't really do anything about it. But sometimes you need to just activate it. Certain songs need to be activated. Certain songs just take over the airwaves just like that. Naturally, they just take over. But some of the songs, you need to activate them. And so in activating it, that's where the dance challenges, you know, come into play. Apart from that, if the song is good, the product is good, why not? It will definitely do well. It's just that you need to, in terms of marketing, you just need to activate it in different ways. So people are doing open verse challenges where, you know, you do your own freestyle on the song with the artist, the original artist, or you could go with the dance challenge, or you could just, you know, just mime to the songs. So there are different challenges. It's just that now the dance challenges are more popular in activating music. But that doesn't mean that if your song, if you release a song and you don't do a dance challenge to it, it's not gonna do good. Yeah. I could never choose. I'm always asked that question. I could never choose between one, because at the end of the day, these two are part of me. So I can never choose one and then leave one. Music has to do with the message first. So I'm looking at the message. I'm looking at what feeling is gonna give people at the end of the day. I look at that before I even look at how to activate the song. You understand? So you need to certify that your song is good when it comes to the lyrics, when it comes to the beat, the arrangement, the composition. Everything has to be on point before you start looking at ways to activate it. You understand? Unless you want to do like a viral dance song, and then that's where you probably think of just a dance challenge. But then in my circle, or the small that I've learned from being in this industry, is it's either you want to be a viral artist or you want to be here for a very long time. You understand? Somebody can just blow up with just one song, pam, and then you're not hearing from them again. You understand? But that's not what we want to do. We want to do music professionally for a long time. So I'm not looking at doing just viral songs. You understand? There are songs that are not really popular, but their numbers are crazy on the digital platforms, and people actually love it. Sit down and then listen to it. I want to make songs that people will sit down and then listen to it. I want to make songs that people would go to the party and then jam to it. So you have different songs serving different purposes. You understand? And then when all these things come together, it makes you a perfect artist. So yeah, I'm not just looking at the dance part or the dance challenge part. You get it? Well, it has set me apart, like I said. It's made me different from everybody else in terms of my performances, my delivery on beats. But most importantly, I think that it's the music itself, and then the brand Mr. Drew, the personality behind the brand Mr. Drew, is what has been more beneficial. The rest would follow later, as in how I dance and all that would follow later. But I feel like if your personality, the song that you also bring out, is not good, nobody would actually pay attention, right? So yeah, I'd say follow your music, follow your creativity, follow what you feel like doing. Don't just do anything. You are the one making the music, you understand? So you know what is gonna work for your music. So don't just, I doubt anybody would just do anything. Every artist knows what he or she wants. So I doubt that anybody would try and do anything just like that. I'm sure that they have, with them doing the song and then even plan going ahead to release a song or planning to release the song, they have a plan in mind to either activate it in a different way, you understand, from what everybody else is doing. So it depends. If there isn't music, how are you gonna dance? You understand? If there isn't something to dance to, how are you gonna dance? You can't be dancing to no sound. You get it? So the music definitely has to come, and then the dance will follow. And definitely music is gonna come before the dance. That's how I feel as an artist. No, I think from that point, then it would be kind of something personal, because I don't think somebody would just get up and just say that, you understand? Unless it's a personal issue that probably they want to address. But aside that, there are various ways you can promote your music. Even before, like I said, even before dance challenges became a thing, people were promoting their songs in different ways. It went from traditional radio to whatever. And then now they have social media. You could literally be doing a freestyle on your TikTok, whatever, and then it could pick up. It could just blow up. So I don't think any dancer would probably, you know, come out to attack anybody unless it's personal. You get it? So yeah, apart from that, well, everybody's cool. Everybody's come.
Today, we've delved into how important dance is to music and vice versa, how it's aided helping creatives follow their dreams, looking at young dancers, DJs, and artists on the impact and scope of how far and wide dance can actually help these artists reach a wider audience. It's incredible to witness how, even though it's taken some time in this part of the world, the incredible impact dance is now having on us as a people. We have to promote this wonderful piece of art much, much further.